My name is Amarjot Singh, and I offer immigration services to people all over the world. And my fee model is primarily consultation. I offer consultation and advice so that they can do their cases on their own. Of course, I will sometimes take their full cases, but that is not my primary focus. My objective is to help people get the right information, right knowledge, so that perhaps they can do it themselves and save money in the long term. The system that we have in our company is that I have two people who look at my messages, WhatsApp messages, YouTube comments, email, and then sort out which messages are extremely important, which are some important, which are not important at all. And then we send them a message about our consultation policy. If they want to take an appointment, then they can fill the information and then set up appointment using a calendar on the form. So that's the way we do this. But many people ask me, why are you charging a fee when other people, other lawyers are offering this free? So that's why we have to make this video so that we can give you our analysis on what is the justification for charging consultation fees. So as I'm showing on the screen, as you can see. So I've listed close to about five different points why is this fee required. So number one, free service has no value. When you go to buy something in the market, do you look for free stuff? I mean, when you go to a restaurant, do you ask for free food? Or do you ask for a free sample? Or do you ask for free anything? Or when you look to buy essential services like medicine, how about when you buy medicines? Do you look for somebody who's offering for free? I mean, if a pharmacist or chemist, they offer you free medicine, it's very likely you won't even trust them because, you know, you have not imputed a value on it. You know, sometimes in my consultation sessions, if I give it for free, you may listen to my information, but there's no incentive to take notes or to pay serious attention. Once you have paid a fee for my advice, you are telling me and yourself there's a value to that information. That means you consider that information important enough. If it is free, then it's free for you. It's free for everybody. It has no value. You do not know. How much importance do we have to pay to this information? You know, also, in other words, if you think that that information is valueless, why even come to the consultant and ask this information? Because it has no value. You know, when you go to Google, Google is full of free advice, but has it helped you? I mean, you can do all kinds of search on. You can go to the government website. You can search for anything. It's absolutely free. But still, people are struggling to find the right information according to their situation, and they cannot find it. That's why. Let me reemphasize, free service has no value. That's my point number one. Let's look at point number two. When you work in your own company where you are working, you get a salary. I mean, if your boss tells you, sorry, there's no salary this month, will you work for free? Ask yourself, will you work for free? I don't think so. Or if you are charging some price to your customers, if you're a businessman, do you sell something for free? I don't think so. Nobody does that for free. Why are they expecting me to give them free? I don't understand. How about the airline? You know, when you buy a ticket from the airline, if you're coming to Canada, you have to buy a ticket, you know. Does the airline say, so, you know, sorry, you know, I'm sorry, we are charging a fee, but hey, by the way, this week, next month, all flights are free. Come on in, hop on in. The seats are available. You can come and sit it up. So they charge you a price to board the airline, but you don't complain to the airline. You know, you always say, you know, no problem. I'll borrow the money and I'll buy the airline ticket. What about the embassy? Don't they charge a non-refundable fee to apply? Do you tell the embassy why you're charging an application fee? Or do you ask the embassy to allow you to apply for free? What if your employer asks you to work for free just for one day because they have no money? Will you continue working? I don't think so. When it does not apply in your case, why do you expect anybody else to work for free? When I charge a consultation fee, that pays for my expenses, that pays for my income, that pays for my everything. So, you know, I am charging a fee to provide something of value to somebody, and that is what is the small fee. I mean, instead of wasting thousands of dollars to somebody else and say, look, do my application, and still the application is not approved, you know, I charge a small fee, and small fee is all I need. I mean, I don't need $1,000. I need only $275, and that's all it is. Look at clause number three, refundable clause. You know, when clients tell me that they are not satisfied with my information, I will refund them. Have you met any lawyer? Have you met any consultant? Have you met anybody else in this business who will refund the consultation fee? I don't think so. If you find them, let me know. I want to talk to them myself. But I will gladly refund the consultation fee if you told me that the consultation session did not answer all your questions or you did not learn anything new. How many consultant lawyers you have contacted so far? Promise to refund the fee? I don't think so. You know, check it out. Find out if somebody will refund it, but I will. That's number three. Look at number four. Once you have paid a fee, you will take action on it. You know, if you have been thinking of applying for some time, it didn't take any step now. Once you have paid a consultation fee, you'll start the application process because now you are physically invested in the process because you have spent $275, you will start working on it. It is a concrete step that you will take to start working on the plan. But if it was free, there was no incentive for you to do nothing at all. And then you could have, you know, sitting back as you were for many years. So that's number four. Look at number five. After the consultation, once you learn from me, now you know what you need to do. Either you can take this information to do the application work on your own or search for a lawyer consultant to do it cheaper than me. If I'm expensive, then you can use this information, go to a cheaper lawyer and say, look, I now know what needs to be done. I want you to do it for me, and this is the price I'm willing to pay. So you can negotiate the price with them, no problem at all. But if you choose to have the application done through me, I can adjust the total fee by the consultation that you paid, no problem at all. But I mean, think about this. I am not interested to attract clients so that they can pay me total package fee so that I can do the application form. Yes, one application or two application a month, I will do selectively choose application which I think justifies my role. But 80% of the time, I will tell people, you know, you don't have to do it through me. And take the information from me. There's a value to it. There's a price to it. And then do it on your own or find out somebody who's cheaper. So that's all I had to say. This is my justification for charging consultation fee. Hey, if you agree, that's fine. Then we can do business. If not, hey, there are thousands of lawyers and thousands of consultants everywhere in this world. And I'm sure you can find a better one to solve your own personal situation. That's all I had to say. So thank you very much. I hope you don't mind. And, have a good day and enjoy the rest of your journey to Canada. Bye-bye.